See beta, in the river and boat problems or river and swimmer problems, beta, we generally just use the basic concept of your relative velocity, isn't it? Relative velocity of A with respect to B, or relative velocity of B with respect to A, whatever you write, na, in the same way we'll be using here. Like the first formula which you need to remember in this one is, like if I'm writing velocity of the swimmer with respect to water, that means this is right now for me what? Velocity of swimmer, velocity of your swimmer with respect to water, beta, with respect to water. The next terminology, velocity of water with respect to ground, VWG, that will be representing me the velocity of water, velocity of water with respect to ground, with respect to ground. Then we talk about velocity of swimmer with respect to ground. That means VSG, this is your velocity of your swimmer with respect to ground, with respect to ground. Isn't it? Like we use velocity of A with respect to B, velocity of A minus velocity of your B. Same thing here also we are writing, beta, isn't it? Velocity of water with respect to ground, we generally represent it by your U. Velocity of swimmer with respect to water, we generally represent it by your V. Clear? Now if I'm writing the equation of your equation for velocity, like velocity of swimmer with respect to water, that will be equal to velocity of your swimmer, velocity of your swimmer with respect to ground, minus velocity of water with respect to ground. Because ground we always take it as a rest. That means if I'm talking about velocity of, from this one, velocity of swimmer with respect to ground means, what I'll write better? Velocity of your swimmer with respect to, velocity of your swimmer with respect to water plus velocity of water with respect to ground. Isn't it? Velocity of swimmer with respect to water will be equal to how much for me? Velocity of swimmer with respect to ground minus velocity of water with respect to ground. Velocity of water with respect to ground, we are representing it by letter U. Velocity of swimmer with respect to water, we are representing it by your V. Velocity of swimmer with respect to ground means Vs, the ground velocity will always be taken as of your zero. So velocity of swimmer with respect to ground, if I'm taking out, this will become for me velocity of swimmer with respect to water plus velocity of water with respect to ground. Clear for everyone? Is it clear? Is this terminology clear for everyone? Velocity of swimmer with respect to water means velocity of swimmer minus velocity of water. With respect to what? With respect to ground. Is it equation clear for everyone? Chalo, let me give you one example. See this one question. So for example, if I say that a boat is sailing at a velocity of 3i cap plus 4j cap, okay, with respect to ground, with respect to ground, and water in river is flowing with a velocity like say minus 3i cap minus of 4j cap. So relative velocity of the boat, relative velocity of the boat with respect to water, with respect to water is, can anyone tell me? Options are 8j cap, second option is 5 into root 2, third option is 6i cap plus 8j cap, and fourth option is minus 6i cap minus of your 8j cap. Can anyone try this one better? take a minute of your time and try to see whether you can do it or not. A boat is sailing at a velocity of your 3i cap plus 4j cap with respect to ground, and water in the river is flowing with velocity minus 3i cap minus j cap. Relative velocity of boat with respect to water. Velocity of your boat with respect to water. That means velocity of the boat with respect to ground minus velocity of water with respect to ground. Isn't it? So velocity of boat is how much, beta? Boat is sailing with a velocity. This is the velocity of boat. And this is the velocity of your water or river, whatever you can take. Isn't it? So that will be equal to your 3 into your I cap plus 4 into your J cap minus velocity of water with respect to ground is how much? Minus of 3 I cap minus of 4 into J cap. So just multiply I cap to I cap, you can multiply J cap to J cap, you can multiply. So 3, how much I'm getting, better, right? 3i cap and 3i cap. So not multiplication, subtraction. Minus, minus of minus, that will become for me plus. That means this will become for me 6i cap. And 4, 4, 8. That means this will become for me plus 8j cap. So this will be the velocity of boat with respect to what? Clear for everyone? Dheeraj? I'm just using this equation, beta. Velocity of swimmer with respect to water is equals to velocity of swimmer with respect to ground minus velocity of water with respect to ground. Clear? Now, if I ask the reverse of this one, can anyone tell me what will be the answer, beta? Velocity of your water with respect to boat, if I ask. It means velocity of water minus velocity of boat with respect to ground only, no? So that will be equal to velocity of water with respect to this one means this is minus of 3i cap minus of your 4j cap subtracting boat with respect to ground. 3i cap plus 4j cap. So it is minus a 3i minus of that one. That means this will become for me minus of 6i cap. Is it? Minus 4 plus, that will be equal to minus of your 8j cap. What is asking the problem? Velocity of boat with respect to the water. That means our answer will be equal to third one. Clear? Chalo. Next one. Upstream and downstream. Okay, let's see here. If the river is moving in this direction, beta. Okay, and boat is also moving in the same direction. Okay, this is your boat. Velocity of the boat is say V. Water is moving with your U. If you are moving in the same direction, net velocity of the boat and that one, both of them are moving in the same direction. That is known as what, beta? Downstream. If both of them are moving in the same direction, it is known as of what? Downstream. Clear? So in downstream, it will be adding this one, both of them, U plus V. Okay. Now upstream, if the boat is moving in opposite direction, like say this is your boat. This boat is moving in opposite direction with a velocity V. Isn't it? So it will be your upstream. Against the water current. If you're moving against the water current, U minus of V. Okay.
సార్ మామూలుగా అయితే రిలేటివ్ ఎలాస్టిలో ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ లో ఉండే యాడ్ చేస్తాం సేమ్ డైరెక్షన్ లో ఉండే మైనస్ చేస్తాం కదా సార్
యా హియర్ రైట్ నౌ వాట్ ఇస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ ఇస్ ఇన్ ద డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్ వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ది బాడీ దట్ మీన్స్ ద రివర్ ఈస్ మేకింగ్ యూ ఆల్సో టు ఇంక్రీజ్ యువర్ స్పీడ్ హియర్ రైట్ నౌ That is the reason we are calling it as a fjord downstream.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Upstream means you are going in which direction, beta? Opposite. Isn't it? If V is dominating, then we write during upstream V minus U, but not U minus V. Make sure of that. Because you are going against the water current, that means your speed will be more compared to U, no? That is the reason during the upstream, if your speed is more, you will be writing it as V minus U, but not U minus V. Clear?
Yes, sir, clear.
Isn't it? So downstream U plus V, upstream is V minus U, but not U minus, sorry, V minus U, but not U minus V. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Sure. So downstream is same direction, U plus V, opposite direction if you are going, that is known as of your upstream. Let me give an example, get a clarity. Say for example, if I say that a boat covers certain distance between two spots on a river. Very good question, beta. On a river, taking T1 time. Taking T1 time, going downstream and T2 time, going upstream. Going upstream. Now the question is, what time will be taken by the boat to cover the same distance in your still water. So boat covers certain distance between two spots on a river, taking T1 time. I'm giving the options for this one. First option is T1 plus T2 divided by 2. Second option is T1 by 2 plus of your 3 by 4 times of T2. Third option is 2 times of T1 T2 divided by your T1 plus T2. And fourth option is T1 plus T2 divided by 2 times of your T1 into T2. So boat covers a certain distance between two spots on a river, taking T1 time in going downstream and T2 time taking in the upstream. That means water is flowing in this direction. Velocity of water, I'm taking it as of your U. Okay. In the first case, this is your boat. This is moving in this direction, V. Okay. And you have got some points here, point A, and this is your point B. So distance between them is, say, for example, D. Very good, C. So boat covers certain distance between two spots, like A and B are two spots on a river, taking T1 seconds. That means to go from A to B, it is taking for me how much? T1 seconds. Isn't it? That means I can write for this one, T1 is equals to distance D divided by V plus U. Both of them are in the same direction. That means I can write from this one, D will be equal to your T1 into your U plus of your V. Clear? Next one. Now the boat is going in this direction with a velocity V. River is flowing in the front direction. So time taken to go from the same spot, point B to the point A, the distance between them is how much for me? D. So that will be equal to D divided by your V minus U. So from this one, I can write D is equals to T2 into your V minus U. Isn't it? In both the cases, the distance is same, no? Isn't it? So, equating equation 1 and 2. Equating 1 and 2. So, what I'll be get? So, it is a T1 into your U plus V will be equal to your T2 into your V minus U. So, if I simplify this one, T1 into U plus T1 into V is equals to T2 into V minus T2 into your U. So, all the U terms you can take on one side, beta, isn't it? So, it is your T1 plus of your T2 into your U will be equal to all the V terms on one side. So, it is V into your T2 minus of your T1. Isn't it? So, what is asking the problem? What will be the, what time will it take by the boat to cover the same distance in the still water? So, I will be getting from this one the initial velocity U. So, U will be equal to how much? U is equals to V into your T2 minus of T1 divided by T1 plus of your T2. You can see it once. I took the value of U out. So, T1 plus T2 will go down. So, it is V into your T2 minus T1 divided by T1 plus T2. So, time taken will be equal to much, ma'am? Distance by your velocity. Isn't it? So, T is equals to your D by your V. Clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, what are we getting right now? Can you tell me? So, that will be equal to your D divided by your V. Yeah. See how much I'm getting now.
D into T1 plus T2 by V into T minus T2.
So this one is your D. This will be equal to your T1 plus T2 divided by your V into your T2 minus of T1. Isn't it? And if I eliminate their D and V, if I eliminate your D and as well as of your V, so what I can write? D by V can be written as anyone?
T, sir.
Why T?
S is equal to VT.
In the given options, particularly as per the given data, the options are not in the terms of your D, it is in terms of your time T1 and as well as of your T2. See, from equation number 2, I can write D is equals to T2 into V minus T2 into your U. Isn't it? I can write this value of your D in the given condition in the place of D and simplify this one. We'll be getting the time T is equals to 2 times of your T1 into T2 divided by T1 plus T2. So, this will be the time taken. Okay. Very important model, beta. So, when a boat covers certain distance between the two spots on a river, taking the time T1 going downstream and T2 time going upstream, what time will they take the boat to cover the same distance in the still water? In the still water means the distance will be equal to remain same for me. So, time taken will be equal to your distance it traveled by velocity. What velocity? Initial velocity. So, if I simplify that one, that will get me the answer for that. Like, I'll give you one example based on this formula. See this one. If I say that a motor boat covers a distance between two points in say for example 4 hours along the flow. Along the flow means
downstream,
and 8 hours opposite to the flow. Opposite to the flow, that means upstream. And how much time this distance can be covered? This distance can be covered in your still water. So for need for such type of equation, time saving tactic is for this one. How much for me? The same formula what we did it. I'll give the options for this one. It is 16 by 3 hours. Second one is your 8 by 3 hours. Third one is 3 by 16 hours. And fourth one is 3 by 8 hours. Anyone? The motor boat covers a distance between 2 points in 4 hours along the flow and 8 hours opposite to the flow. So I can take the direct shortcut formula. T is equals to 2 times of T1 to go downstream and T2 to go the upstream divided by T1 plus T2. That's it. Very good. So that is equals to 2 into 4 into your 8 divided by 4 plus 8. Then it is 2 into 4 into 8 divided by 4 plus 8 is nothing but 12. So 4 ones are 4, 3s are 8, 2s are 16. 16 by your 3. 16 by 3 hours. Clear? Clear, brother? Next one is concept of your river crossing. Very basic thing, but again, same simple application of your relative velocity. First one is, if I'm talking about your shortest distance, that means minimum drift. Shortest distance means minimum drift. Okay, like say, this one and this one. This is your distance between them. From here, if the boat is moving with certain velocity like this, this is the velocity of swimmer with respect to river or boat with respect to river. And distance between them will be equal to your D. Okay. So this is your point A and this is your point B. Then, madam, the width of the river is how much for me? D. And the swimmer is moving, making an angle theta with your vertical. Isn't it? So, if I'm going in this direction, velocity of the river will be in which direction, madam? Velocity of the river with respect to ground will be in the positive direction. So, this will give me what? Velocity of your. This direction will give me velocity of your swimmer with respect to ground finally, so that he will be reaching exactly at a point B. He will be reaching exactly at your point of your B. Now, can anyone tell me what do you write this one? Velocity of swimmer with respect to the ground winds. I can write this one is equals to under root of your velocity of swimmer with respect to river. I am taking it as of your V, and I am taking this one as of your U. That means this will become for me V square minus of your U square. Isn't it? See, condition is river velocity must be lesser than the velocity of man. This is the river. River velocity must be lesser than your velocity of your swimmer with respect to river. In that condition, I can write sine theta will be equal to your U by your V, or angle made by this one will be equal to sine inverse of your U divided by V. U is the velocity of river and V is the velocity of your swimmer with respect to the river. Okay. So now I can say that angle made by swimmer with flow, that is alpha, this total angle alpha. So that will be equal to how much, beta? Theta plus 90 degrees. Theta means that will be equal to sine inverse of your U by V plus theta will be equal to your pi by 2. Isn't it? Now, if he's asking time required to cross the river, time required to cross the river, time required to cross the river. So T is equals to D divided by under root of your V square minus U square. So that will be the time taken. Drift will be zero because the particle is exactly reaching at a point B. So there will be no drift. That is the reason we are taking the minimum drift will be equal to zero. X will be equal to zero. Clear for everyone? Is it clear, Veda?
Sir, what is drift?
Shortest distance. A to B is your shortest distance or minimum drift. Condition for that one is what? U must be lesser than the velocity of your boat or velocity of swimmer. So sine theta from the figure I can write as U by V. So theta is equal to sine inverse of U by V. Now time required to cross the river formula. So time required to cross the river will be equal to your T divided by under root of your V square minus of your U square. And drift will be zero here. That means X value will become for me zero. Angle made by the swimmer with the flow will be equal to theta plus alpha. See the diagram there. Clear for everyone? Is it clear? Chalo. Let me do one example on this one. See this question. Like say, a boat can row with a speed of 10 kilometer per hour in still water. Okay, the river flow steadily at 5 kilometer per hour and the width of river is say 2 kilometers. Okay. If the boat cross the river with minimum distance, okay, then question is time elapsed will be how much? First option is 2√3 divided by 5 hour. Next one is 2 divided by 5 into root 3 hour. Third one is 3√2 divided by 5 hour. And fourth one is 5√2 divided by 3 hour. So try to do it anyway. A boat can row with a speed of 10 km per hour in your still water. The river flow is steadily at your 5 km per hour. That means velocity of river is 5 km. Width of the river is given as of your 2 kilometers. If the boat crosses the river in minimum distance, then time elapsed will be equal to your how much? Chapara. Second option. Inka evarana? Dheeraj?
Not getting.
Aranya, 2. Nandini? A boat can row with a speed and a velocity of your boat is equals to 10 km per hour and velocity of river is equals to 5 km per hour. Distance between them is given as of your 2 kilometers. He's asking time elapsed. What is the formula, beta? Very good. T is equals to distance divided by under root of your V square minus U square. So T is equals to distance between them is how much? 2 kilometers divided by under root of V is equals to 10 whole square minus of 5 whole square. That is 2 divided by under root of 10 square is your 100 minus 25. So that is 2 divided by root of your 75. Isn't it? So root of your 75 means how can I write that one, beta? Pi root 3. Very good. T is equals to 2 divided by 5 into your root 3. Clear? Clear? Sure. One more question. Say, for example, a boat which has a speed of 5 km per hour in your still water, in your still water, crosses a river of width 1 km along the shortest path, along the shortest possible path in 15 minutes. Okay. The velocity of the river in kilometer per hour is. Want to try to do it? Anyone? Boat has a speed. That means velocity of the boat is given for me. A boat which has a speed of 5 km per hour in the still water crosses the river of width. So velocity of your boat is equals to 5 km per hour. And width is given for me as 1 km. Shortest possible time. Time is equals to your 15 minutes. Velocity of your river is equals to your how much? Okay. Distance is given as 1 kilometer. So time t is equals to d divided by under root of your v square minus of your u square. Distance between them is how much for me? 1 kilometer divided by under root of your, this one is your v, velocity of the boat is nothing but v, 5 square minus velocity of the river. We need to calculate u square. And time taken is how much for me? 15 minutes. 15 minutes means in hours, how much it will be? 1 by 4 hour. 15 minutes will be equal to 1 by 4 hour. So time will be equal to 1 by 4. That is equals to your 1 divided by under root of 5 square is 25 minus u square. Okay. Now simplify this one. How much you are getting, you see? Under root of your 25 minus u square is equals to 4. That means 25 minus u square is equals to how much? 16. So u square will be equal to how much, beta? How much? 9. So u will be equal to how much? 3 kilometer per hour. Clear? Any doubt in this one? So, everyone is clear about the shortest distance concept related to this one. So, the next one we'll try to do it out. Shortest time. Shortest time. That's it. This is your width of the river. Distance between them is, say for example, d. And water is flowing in the front direction. Velocity of the water is u. Then this is the perpendicular distance. You are starting from the point A. We need to go in the shortest time, means we need to go in the direction of your river. That means downstream or upstream, beta? In the direction means downstream. So if I take the direction like this, isn't it? That means from the shore, I am making an angle of theta. This is the velocity of swimmer with respect to ground, isn't it? So velocity of river is going in this direction. This will be the velocity of river with respect to ground. That will be equal to u. And this will be the velocity of your swimmer with respect to your river. If I'm moving exactly perpendicular to the water, water will push me, and because of that pushing, this body might be meeting somewhere here right now. Somewhere at this position. That means there is a drift of your, how much for me? X. So I'm starting at your A. I was supposed to reach at B, but now I'm reaching at your point C. Isn't it? SG is nothing but velocity of swimmer with respect to ground. That is your relative velocity. Resultant of this one. So that resultant, how do you write this one, beta? Velocity of swimmer with respect to ground will be equal to under root of your u square plus p square, or v square plus u square, anything. Isn't it? Velocity of swimmer with respect to ground will be equal to that much. Clear? Then what is this horizontal distance? Horizontal distance will be equal to horizontal velocity into time. So time taken to cross this one will be equal to how much for me? D by V, velocity of your swimmer with respect to your river. That I am taking it as of your V. Okay. So that is equals to your X is equals to your U. T is equals to distance divided by velocity. That is your drift. So what is an angle made by this one beta? Sine theta is equals to. Anyone? Sine theta will be equal to how much beta? Yeah. V by under root of your V square plus of your U square. That means tan theta will be equal to how much beta? V by U from the figure. Then the shortest time, the relation what you need to remember for the NEET exam is velocity of swimmer with respect to ground. That is under root of U square plus V square. And the drift of that one is calculated by the formula X. X is equals to your U into D by your V. The angle made by that one will be equal to your V divided by your under root of V square plus U square. And tan theta will be equal to V by U. Clear? Clear, beta? See this question, madam. So for example, if I say that man observes rain falling vertically down. Vertically downwards with 6 meters per second. Calculate the actual velocity. Actual velocity of rain. If man is running with 4 meters per second. Chalo, come on, try to do it. A man observes the rain is falling vertically down. That means this is the velocity of your rain. And velocity of rain with respect to man. This is the velocity of rain with respect to man. That is how much for me? 6. isn't it? And this is the velocity of the man who is running in the front direction. Velocity of the man is moving in the front direction. For him, the rain is appearing to hit him vertically. Isn't it? That means velocity of your rain with respect to your man plus velocity of your man will be equal to velocity of rain. Isn't it? So if I'm taking the resultant of this one, magnitude of this one, that will be under root of velocity of rain with respect to man whole square plus velocity of man whole square. That is equals to under root of velocity of man with respect to 6 square plus velocity of man is equals to how much beta? Man observes rain falling vertically downwards with velocity 6 meter per second. Calculate the actual velocity of the rain. The man is moving with your 4 meter per second. So this one is your 4 square. That is under root of 6 square is 36 plus 4 square is 16. That will be equal to how much? 30, 40, 50. That is root of your 52 meter per second. Clear? One more question, beta. Important model. Say, for example, a man is running with 4 meter per second, observes rain falling behind him with 6 meter per second at angle of 60 degrees with vertical. Done. My question is, calculate the actual velocity and the angle of rainfall with vertical. Good question. Okay, a man is running with what velocity? 4 meter per second in the front direction. So velocity of the man is moving in the front direction. So this is the velocity of your man. Man is running with your 4 meter per second. Rain appears to fall him behind him. That means here is the velocity of your rain with respect to your man vertically. Fall behind him with a velocity of your 6 meter per second at an angle of 60 degrees with vertical. At an angle of 60 degrees with vertical. So this angle will be 90 degrees. Isn't it? Calculate the actual velocity and the angle of the rainfall with the vertical. Okay. That means velocity of your rain with respect to your man will be equal to velocity of rain minus velocity of your man. That means velocity of rain with respect to man plus velocity of your man will be the actual velocity of the rain. We are. Isn't it? So now, angle between them is how much beta? 90 plus 60. So if I'm calculating the magnitude of velocity of rain, that will be under root of your velocity of rain with respect to man whole square plus velocity of your man whole square plus 2 times of velocity of rain with respect to man into velocity of your man into cos of your 150 degrees. Cos 150 is how much beta? Under root of velocity of rain with respect to man is 6 whole square plus 4 whole square plus 2 into 6 into 4 into cos 150. Anyone? Cos 150. 90.
Cos 90 plus 60.
Positive or negative? Obviously negative. So this will be equal to how much for me? Minus of root 3 by 2. So this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled here. So that will be equal to under root of your 6 square is 36 plus 4 fours are 16. This one is nothing but minus This will be equal to how much for me beta? 24 into root 3. That means this will come out for me under root of your 36 plus 16, 30, 40, 52. 52 minus of 24 root 3. So this is the actual velocity of your ring. Clear? Under root of 52 minus 24 root 3. Now if I am calculating the angle, actual velocity we got, angle of the rainfall. So what is the actual rainfall making an angle? That means if the diagram, if I am seeing here right now, see, this will be the velocity of your rain, which is making an angle of your alpha here, right? Isn't it? That means with vertical, it is making some angle right now. Like this. Isn't it? So I can use the formula. Tan alpha will be equal to. Tan alpha will be equal to how much? B sine theta divided by A plus B into cos theta. That means velocity of rain with respect to man into sine of your 150 degrees divided by A will be equal to velocity of man plus velocity of rain with respect to man into cos 150 degrees. Okay, that means this will be equal to your A and this will be equal to your B. Clear? So if I simplify this one, tan alpha is equals to velocity of rain is 6 into sine 150 is 1 by 2 divided by velocity of minus 4 plus this one is 6 minus of root 3 by 2. Cos 150 is minus of root 3 by 2. That means I'll be getting the value of tan alpha. Tan alpha will be equal to 2 ones are 2 threes are. So this is your 3 divided by your 4. 2 ones are 2 threes are plus minus 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 of your 3 root 3. That means alpha will be equal to alpha is equals to your tan inverse of your 3 divided by 4 minus 3 into root 3. Isn't it? With vertical, if he's asking, then that will be equal to how much? 90 minus alpha. So that will be equal to 90 minus pi by 2. Pi by 2 minus this one will be equal to your tan inverse of 3 by 4 minus 3 into root 3. That will be the answer. Clear? Good question, beta. Small calculations only, nothing much. Big calculations are there. But it depends upon how he's asking. That's it. Clear? Sure. One more and last question based on this topic, beta. Good model. Please try to practice the models which I'm sending you and I'm doing in the class compulsorily. Rain is, say for example, falling with 3 meter per second at 60 degrees with vertical ahead of a person. With what speed he must run in order to observe the rainfall with same speed falling at 60 degrees behind him with vertical. Okay, chalo, try to do it. Rain is falling with 3 meter per second at 60 degrees with vertical. That means if this is your vertical, velocity of your rain with respect to your man. Is how much for me? 3 meters per second at an angle of 60 degrees with vertical. Clear? Now, with vertical ahead of your person, ahead of your person. That means like this, vertical. With the speed, with what speed he must run in order to observe the rain falls him, it is speed, the same speed falling at 60 degrees behind him. That means now this one is behind him. This one is 60 degrees. This is the velocity of rain. That is equals to 3 meter per second. Isn't it? Now just try to resolve it. If I'm resolving it, we'll get one component here, and we'll get one component here. Isn't it? So velocity of your now just resolve this one beta. Velocity of river with respect, sorry, rain with respect to man. If I'm resolving it, it's into components. So here it will become for me cos, and here it will become for me sine. That means this is the velocity of your rain with respect to man into your sine of your 60 degrees. Isn't it? The same way. Horizontal component, this will be equal to how much one? Velocity of your rain. This is VR into your sine of your 60 degrees. So man is moving in the horizontal direction, you know. So velocity of your man will be equal to velocity of rain with respect to man into your sine of your 60 degrees plus velocity of your rain into your sine of 60 degrees. Isn't it? Because the man is moving in this direction. Right? So this is the velocity of man. Summation of both of this one. That will give me the answer directly. Velocity of rain with respect to man is how much for me beta? 3. Sine 60 is nothing but root 3 by 2 plus. Velocity of rain is 3. Sine 60 is nothing but how much for me? Root 3 by 2. That means 3 root 3 by 2 plus 3 root 3 by 2. That means it will be a 6 root 3 by 2. That means it will become for me 2 ones are 2 threes are. 3 root 3 meter per second. This will be the answer. You can do it like this, or else you can do it by the general method also, relative velocity concept. Method 2. Like velocity of rain with respect to man will be equal to velocity of rain minus velocity of man. So velocity of man I need, no? So velocity of man will be equal to velocity of rain minus rain with respect to man, that's it. Magnitude, if I'm taking, magnitude of this one, velocity of man will be equal to under root of your VR square plus velocity of rain with respect to man whole square minus 2 times of velocity of rain with respect to man into cos of your 120 degrees, because angle in between both of them is how much? 120 degrees. Cos 120, you already know it, minus. So that will be equal to velocity of rain. That will be equal to how much for me? 3 square plus this one is your 3 square minus 2 into 3 into 3 into cos 120 is minus of 1 by 2. This one will get cancelled. Under root of 3 square is 9 plus 9 minus minus plus 3 3 is a 9. Isn't it? So that will be equal to how much for me? 18 plus 9, that will be equal to root 27. So root 27 means this will be 2-3 root 3 meter per second. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can do it. Clear? clear beta sure so now you please try to practice the motion and plane problems river and boat problems once beta and we'll try to do some more problems on the circular motion in tomorrow the heading is coming circular motion beta don't take it out that is river and boat problem also motion and plane we'll try to do some circular motion problems basic problems in the tomorrow session of your class okay bye beta